Hi there, and welcome to Are You Watching the Game podcast. My name is Aiden Maddox. I got my co-host here,
Joseph Parsons,
and we're going to be talking with Sophia Aaron-Holtz about girls golf.
Sir. All right, and what are your pregame routines looking like?
So basically, I just go out to the practice green and practice chipping and putting, and then I like to stretch before because usually I get either like really bad back pain or knee pain, so stretching helps with that. And then if the school has a driving range, I always go to a driving range to help with long distance.
Could you please explain what chipping is? Because I know a little bit about putt-putt, but I do not know what chipping is.
Chipping's just pretty much when you're off the green, hitting it onto the green, and you kind of got to get it up in the air so it doesn't fly off the green.
So it's like practicing if you were like to hit it in the sand pit or something like that? Okay, that's good.
Who do you look up to as like a coach or a player, anyone?
I really look up to my older sister because she started off about how I started off with okay scores, and now she's golfing for her college. So
That's nice. Exciting. What are your hobbies outside of school?
I like to play piano. I've been playing for 4 years now.
It's hard.
And I also like to crochet, and I've taken that up pretty recently, but I really enjoy it.
That's good. What's your favorite song to play on the piano?
My favorite song to play right now is one I've just been starting working on. It's called Song of the Lark, and it's like you can actually hear birds in it, so I really like that one.
Have you crocheted anything yet?
Yeah, I crocheted a narwhal a couple weeks ago, and then yesterday I crocheted a jellyfish.
That's good. That's pretty cool. Yeah. What do you think some of your weaknesses and strengths are?
For weaknesses, I tend to really rush myself when I'm golfing, so that messes me up sometimes, and I get really far into my head when I'm not doing great.
Oh, yeah.
So
it's understandable. I mean, it happens to the best of us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then for strengths, I am pretty strong, so I can hit the ball far, which at my age group for golf, you don't see that in a lot of girls.
Right.
It's mainly their technique. And so, and then I also usually am in good spirits when I'm golfing because I enjoy golfing. And so it's something I like to do.
Gotta stay in a good mindset.
Oh, something you have fun with. It's always good to play.
Oh, yeah. And what would you say is the biggest challenge you face being a student athlete?
The biggest challenge is probably finding time for myself just to unwind, because I'm either usually on a golf course or practicing for another sport or doing schoolwork. And all of my siblings are also student athletes, so I'm usually at one of their games. So it's hard for me to find time just to like be by myself and do something I enjoy.
And actually have time. Yeah.
Yeah. No, yeah.
I noticed that. That's a
it's
very
between everyone.
Trend.
Yeah.
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 Oh, yeah.
How do you like as being the only golfer and also being a freshman golfer?
It's kind of weird because being a freshman and the only golfer, I'm golfing against every other school's number one golfer.
Right.
And a lot of them are either juniors and seniors and have been golfing in high school for a while. I think in all but one meets, I have gotten second, though, so.
That's pretty nice.
Ooh, yeah. Okay.
And it's weird being a freshman because every time someone's asking, like, what grade are you in? Because they don't expect a freshman to be the number one golfer.
Right.
They're always so surprised when I say freshman, especially since I have been golfing for so long and my scores are somewhat with them, so.
That's good. Okay.
So I heard you played in the junior tournament, or what's that called?
It's called Central Indiana Junior Golf Association.
Yeah. So how'd you like that?
I like it. I get to meet people I won't really golf with for school since most of them are in like the Lafayette area and we don't really go down there for golf. So it's cool. And then for school, we don't really golf 18 holes. So it's a different experience since we golf 18 holes. So.
Yeah. Well, thanks for coming out.
Thanks for having me.
Of course.
And one more time, this is Are You Watching the Game podcast, and we'll see you guys next time.
Yes, sir.
All right. 2 hours later.
Hi there, and welcome to Are You Watching the Game podcast. My name is Aiden Maddox. I'm here with Coach Buchanan of the girls' golf team, and I'll just be talking to him today. So how do you prepare Sophia for the competition?
Sophia is in kind of one of those good, bad positions. Unfortunately, we weren't able to field a full team this year. We couldn't get enough girls that were interested in playing. So with that, she gets all of my attention.
Yeah.
which can be a good thing and a bad thing, because there are times she would probably wish that I would go somewhere else and, you know, help somebody else, yeah. And that's not there. So to prepare her, what we try to do is we look at a couple of facets. We look at it from a mental standpoint, because in the end, a lot of golf is played right here, the 6 inches between your ears.
Oh, yeah.
So we're trying to prepare her to handle the challenges that are going to arise during a round of golf. From a physical perspective, we practice putting and chipping incessantly,
yeah.
because that's where you're going to save your most shots at.
Oh, yeah.
We go out and we play the course, particularly our home course, which happens to be Oak Grove Golf Course down in Oxford.
Right.
To try to get her familiar with the various places that she's likely to play from. Mm. So she's not walking into a shot blind.
Right.
So outside of that, I guess the other preparation that we do, we talk about expectations, where she's at now, where can she be in the future.
Right. Just good things to look for, stuff like that. What do you hope to see Sophia do in the next coming years?
You know, Sophia's has an older sister, has younger sisters also. Her older sister, Madeline, played at North Newton before the family moved down here to Kentland.
Right.
And Madeline is playing at Hanover College. I would expect that Sophia could play in college.
Yeah.
If you compare what they shot at the same timeline in their careers, Sophia is very comparable to Maddie in scoring and in ability. As we move forward, particularly this offseason, we're going to make some fairly significant changes in the way that she hits shots.
That's good.
So there may be a little bit of a step back before she takes that two steps forward. I look forward to seeing her fulfill her goals. As a coach, we always have goals for every player, and those goals are always pretty similar. You want them to be the best they can be and make all conference and possibly, you know, all sectional and,
yeah.
You know, and then ultimately maybe get a scholarship to play in college. But the most important thing is that we're letting her meet what she wants for a goal.
Right. You want her to meet her expectations, not just yours.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's good. How do you see the girls' golf program in the next 5 years or so?
We got to get some players. You know, and it's not just the girls. It's the boys' team as well. 2 years ago, when I took over the golf program for the boys, we had a team of six. This past year, we had a team of four.
Right.
And I'm not sure what to do, because I've attended, you know, the sports call-outs, and I've been here at school, you know, trying to introduce myself around and see what we can do to increase interest in the sport. The girls, it's particularly tough, because it appears to me, and I'm relatively new to the area, I've been up here 4 years, it seems like most of the girls want to either play softball or volleyball.
Right.
You know, basketball even, they get a tough time. You know, I watched that last year, you know, girls basketball. I'm not quite sure, you know, what the drawback is, because as you get older and you progress out of high school and through college, and then you get into careers or family, a lot of people decide to take up golf. Well, the cheapest way to learn to play golf is in high school.
Yeah.
Because we try to provide the equipment. I provide the coaching, and I think I'm pretty well educated in that. Having played in college, I played professionally for a while.
Right.
I got a pretty good background.
Got a little education to you.
Yeah, so I'm not sure what we're going to have to do to get some more participation. And if you have an idea, I'm happy to hear it.
Yeah. So how do you see Sophia performing the next meet?
So her next meet, we played yesterday. We played Tri-County yesterday. She struggled a bit with putting. If she had putted better, she would have beaten the young lady that she was playing.
Right.
From tee to green, she was the better player, but when she got around the green, it just didn't quite go the way that she wanted it to go, and she's aware of that. We've talked about that. Her next meet will be the conference meet at Sandy Pines a week from this past Monday. That's going to be a big one for her because she has experience playing Sandy Pine. She played in the Northwest Indiana Junior Tour.
Oh, really?
So she's played there, you know, a few times.
Yeah, she's got
she took lessons from one of the female pros there.
Right.
So in some respects, she's quite versed in that golf course.
Mm-hmm.
So I think maybe her expectation level is a little bit higher than if we were to, you know, play Harrison Hills or to go down south and play Tippecanoe where she's maybe only played once. So her next meet, you know, her season average right now is somewhere around 55 for nine holes.
Wow.
And that's good for a freshman.
Oh, that's really
if we're putting and chipping a little bit better, she would be in the 40s.
Yeah, I definitely couldn't do that. I know that.
So I would like to see her quite simply not have any three putts. If she plays this conference tournament and she doesn't have any three putts, she has a very good chance at the very least being honorable mention all conference.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome. I know you guys got sectionals, I believe, coming up in the next 2 weeks or so.
So we play the conference this coming Monday. Then a week later, we play the sectionals at Tippecanoe. Yeah.
How do you see Sophia competing in that? You think she could possibly win or move on?
Well, I don't know that we're ready to win yet.
Mm-hmm.
If she goes down there, and the competition will be a little bit tougher because right. you're incorporating more teams in the – in the sectional, if she goes down and she shoots her season average of a 55, she's probably got a chance to move on to the regionals.
Right.
If she gets a little bit nervous, a little uncomfortable, gets outside of that zone, then it's going to be tougher.
It's always scary for a freshman going in sectionals, never been there before.
Well, you know, and she's a freshman in name, but, you know, having played junior tournaments, playing with a sister who's playing in college, she's a little bit battle-tested, and she has the right attitude about it. She doesn't get flustered very often. You know, I try to discuss things with her. But ultimately, in the end, as I tell her and as I tell all of my athletes, in the end, you're the person hitting the shot, not me.
Right.
So you need to hit the shot that you're going to have the most confidence in. Oh, yeah. I may have an opinion, but what matters is your opinion.
Yeah, that's totally honest. Well, thank you for coming out. Again, this is the Are You Watching the Game podcast. We'll see you guys next time.
Thank you. Baller, shot caller, 20 in play. Oh. Paula, caller, get late tonight. Switch the roll tight, got